by stating, when you or a loved one has been injured offshore, it's important for you to know what your rights are and what you are entitled to achieve as compensation. When you work with rate and benchmark, you can rest assured that you will be working with a maritime injury lawyer with over 30 years of experience. That automatically ensures that you will have a leg up in court, as almost nothing is more important than experience in a courtroom. Contact a Houston Maritime attorney as soon as possible for your claim. When an offshore injury has occurred, it is important to understand what types of compensation you may be entitled to. Offshore injuries are governed by complex and complicated state and federal laws which govern the type of compensation you may achieve. For this reason, an experienced maritime injury lawyer such as those at Rate and Benchmark will help you tremendously with your case. For a free consultation, please call 713-622-7271 or fill out our online intake form. A brief history of maritime and admiralty law. Maritime law and admiralty law are two terms that can be used interchangeably. Importantly, maritime law, also called admiralty law, is what governs offshore accidents. Maritime workers have almost always adhered to certain specific laws that govern their industry. Although much of general maritime law in the United States comes from the Constitution, there are other sources for these regulations as well. Below we list some of the most important laws, statutes, and regulations that are crucial when it comes to maritime injury cases. The Jones Act, also called the Merchant Marine Act of 1920, the Jones Act extends the Federal Employers Liability Act, FELA, to injured maritime workers. Basically, it allows injured workers in the maritime industry to file personal injury claims against their employer. In order to do this, they must have been injured during the course of their job duties. The crucial statute states the following. A seaman injured in the course of employment, or if the seaman dies from the injury, the personal representative of the seaman may elect to bring a civil action at law, with the right of trial by a jury, against the employer. Laws of the United States regulating recovery for personal injury to or death of a railway employee apply to an action under this section. What is maintenance and cure in maritime law? Two important factors in Jones law cases are maintenance and cure. Maintenance is the compensation that your employer must provide to you while you recover from an illness or injury. The intent behind maintenance is to provide compensation for recovering workers' cost of living on land. However, many maritime employers try to keep these payments to a minimum. Working with experienced maritime attorneys can potentially give you a better chance at a higher maintenance payment in your case. Cure is the medical care that your employer must provide to you after you suffer a work-related injury. It basically compensates for the treatments necessary for your recovery. While many employers don't want you to know this, offshore workers have the right to choose their own doctor under maintenance and cure. One crucial question remains: how long do maintenance and cure benefits last? Generally, maritime and harbor construction workers can achieve these benefits until they reach maximum medical improvement, MMI. MMI is the point when your injury or illness or condition will no longer improve. Once you reach maximum medical improvement, your employer is no longer obligated to pay for further medical bills and treatments. We highly recommend speaking with trained maritime lawyers for your case. We will ensure that all your legal rights and benefits are protected. When does maritime law actually apply? It's important to understand which offshore accident cases actually fall under the jurisdiction of maritime law. In the United States, maritime law applies in any case that arises on navigable waters. Navigable waters are those used for commerce, trade, or travel between multiple states or foreign countries. Any body of water that is fully contained within a single state, such as a lake, is not subject to federal maritime law. Maritime law covers a wide array of maritime accident cases. Examples include cases involving offshore oil rigs, shipping disasters, and other injury cases. It can even come into play in cases of piracy, contract disputes, and even marine insurance issues. Because of the countless case types that fall under maritime law, you need experienced offshore injury lawyers on your side. Maritime attorneys are one of many types of personal injury lawyers. They handle maritime injury cases, body accident cases, and even commercial maritime cases. At our Hobson Law Office, Rick and Binslag is passionate about protecting the rights of injured maritime workers. If you are having trouble securing compensation from your employer or an insurance company, our maritime lawyers are here for you. So I think that's all from me. Thank you for watching. Bye. Oh my God.